Dear God's people, happy solemnity of the presentation of the child Jesus in the temple. As you can see, I am in what is today known as the Wailing Wall or the Temple Mount. That is the remaining of the temple back in Jesus' time. And today I would like to reflect on the gospel which is taken from Luke chapter 2, verse 22 to 40. We see in this gospel Mary and Joseph bringing the child Jesus here in the temple for presentation. Actually, the evangelist is coinciding or is combining two events, because the first event is that in the book of Exodus chapter 13 verse 1 to 16, it is demanded according to the Jewish law that all firstborn are supposed to be redeemed. And so they were supposed to come here to pay a sum so that they can redeem the firstborn. And it was not only to human beings, but also animals. So Mary and Joseph came here to redeem the Redeemer. This is a kind of a mysterious thing. But then in the temple was Simeon, whom through the Holy Spirit have been revealed to him that he will not see death until he sees the Messiah. And Simeon was able to see the Messiah through his fervent perseverance by coming to the temple and pray each day. And also the prophetess Anna, whom also through the Holy Spirit revealed to her that she will also see the Messiah. But it's quite interesting that the life of these two old men, these two old people, especially Simeon and Anne, has a lot to teach us. The gospel tells us that Anne never left the temple. She was here praying night and day. And this is very interesting for us, because as Christians, we are supposed to be in union with God all the time. Maybe not physically present in the church, but carrying God with us wherever we go. So I think this was one particular element that is, you know, important for us to emulate as Christians. Another reason probably why Mary and Joseph came here is the fact that after the 40 days of birth, the mother needed to purify herself. And this was in accordance with Leviticus. So the law of Leviticus demands that the mother needs purification. And so she came here. So you can see that the evangelist Luke is combining these two events so as to bring out a fulfillment prophecies. So, as we reflect in today's solemnity, let us keep in mind the two persons that we meet here that are very important, Anne and Simeon, whom their lives, the way they live their life, help to, you know, for them to experience God's fulfillment, for them to experience the Messiah. Maybe because they lived really very well as they're supposed to live. As Christians, we face a lot of difficulties and sometimes we lack patience. I think we can learn from Anne that if we are patient, that which the Lord has promised us will one day come to be in fulfillment. So we are asked to cultivate the virtue of patience, and also we are asked to cultivate a good Christian virtue so that God will always be with us, so that we will be able to gain eternal life. So another aspect of today's feast is that it's dedicated to consecrated people. So all of us as Christians are consecrated by virtue of our baptism. So we are challenged to live out our baptismal promises. I wish you a pleasant feast, and may God continue to bless you all. Happy Solemnity. Gracias.